Come all you weary, come all you thirsty, come to the well that never runs dry. Drink of the water, come and thirst no more. Come all you sinners, come find his mercy, come to the table he will satisfy. Taste of his goodness, find what you're looking for. His one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. Bring all your failures, bring your addictions, come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting. Come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting. God so loved the world.
Good morning, everyone. And welcome to St. Patrick. Thanks so much for joining us for prayer today. We're going to go over our psalm before we start today. This is from Psalm 4. Lord, let your face shine on us. It goes like this.
Lord, let your face shine on us, shine on us.
Try it together. Ready and sing.
Lord, let your face shine on us, shine on us.
Very nice. And then I think the other pieces we'll know pretty well. We're doing mostly Easter music. We'll be doing In the Breaking of the Bread today. All right. Here comes Father.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Father Stefan, if you don't know who I am. Yeah. I'm still Father Stefan. But happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
We have 50 days of Easter celebrating that Christ has truly risen. And that's what we're celebrating in this third Sunday, that Christ has not only risen, he's in our midst. The risen Lord is with us. And so one of the things we want to just recognize today are those who are first-time visitors, who maybe or maybe someone who's come back for a long time. But if you're visiting here, I invite you to please stand so we can recognize you and welcome you. If you're a first-time here, visitor, thank you. Good to have you here. Wow. Thank you. See, as we gather during this, whenever we gather for Eucharist, we gather as the one body of Christ. Not just as individuals in the building, but one body of Christ. So it's important that we know who we are as we gather for this celebration. So I'd like to invite everyone to please stand and introduce yourself to the person next to you. All right, I'm glad that we can gather and to begin the celebration. So let's just look at our hearts, calm our hearts down, be ready, but really to praise God that he's among us and changing our life, calling us to really renew again our baptism in Christ. Just recognize what he's doing in our hearts.
The morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see, come and see. He is alive. Grave that is empty, a promise fulfilled. God who is with us is here with us still. He is here, he is here, he is alive. Conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive. Sun has arisen for all. Your people sing alleluia. People of God, let your fear fall away. Your chains have been broken, abandon your shame. Lift your heart, lift your heart. He is alive. Hear now his mercy embracing your soul. Hear the fulfillment that once was foretold. It is true, he is alive. Alleluia. Alleluia, love is alive. The sun has arisen for all. Your people sing alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia, love is alive. Conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive. Your sun has arisen for all. Sing alleluia.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our risen Lord be with you all.
With your spirit.
Again, good morning.
Morning.
We gather on this third Sunday, recognizing it's just one Sunday among many Sundays where we celebrate Christ has risen. That his resurrection does make a difference in our life. So much so that we'll hear in the scriptures today what it demands from us, really demand from us, because we've been baptized in Christ. What does it really mean to believe in the risen Lord? So let's prepare ourselves to celebrate this great mysteries by recognizing our own struggles in believing, our own struggles in trying to live our faith. Know that God is always merciful and forgiving.
Lord Jesus, you are King of kings and Lord of lords. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you have come to set us free. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the source of our life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's join in singing together the hymn of the angels.
Sing with us, clap with us, glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to men. people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, oh God, almighty Father. People of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, these two people of goodwill. Alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, this is Lent. We'll go to Easter. So that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our own adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. For Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
I'd like to invite, call forth our catechists, who will lead our children in the liturgy of the word. So I invite the parents to please bless your children. And then children, you're welcome to come to the front of the altar. Parents, you can also assist your children if you wish. Children, go forth now and listen well and carefully to the word of God.
Alleluia, love is alive, conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive, the sun has arisen for all. Your people sing alleluia.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death. But God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
The day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Jesus is risen from the dead.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
Alleluia.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And he said this. He showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you have anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem." You are witnesses of these things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia.
I want to begin by just telling a little story I heard recently. A little boy who decided one day he wanted to go visit God. He knew it was going to be a long trip, so he got his little suitcase out, put some Twinkies in there, and a six-pack of root beer, and he went off. He went about 3 blocks and got to the park and saw an older man there sitting on the bench feeding the pigeons. So he sat down beside the old man. He's getting hungry, so he opened up his suitcase, took out a root beer, looked over to the man and thought, well, he must be hungry. So he took a Twinkies and gave him a Twinkie. And the man smiled at him. And he liked the smile, so he offered him a root beer. This man smiled even better. And he just couldn't believe the smile he was receiving from this man. So they ate there and drank there all day. When the sentiments began to come down, the boy decided, well, it's about time I go home. So he got everything together in his suitcase and started walking away and then stopped, turned around, ran to the old man and gave him a big hug. And the man just completely smiled at him. He loved it. He got home and the mother said, well, where were you all day? Well, I was meeting God. You know, God has a wonderful smile. And meanwhile, the older man came home, and his son was there. And his son goes, Dad, you look so happy. What happened today? He goes, well, you know, I was in the park, and I met God. And you know what? God's much smaller and younger than I thought he'd be. But they're witnessing to each other the presence of God through a smile, through a hug, witnessing. The readings today, especially the first reading in the gospel, both have the word witness. We're called to witness what's going on. And at the very end of the gospel today, he goes, so you are witnesses to these things. What are these things we're witnesses to? So the two men who were on the journey to Emmaus and experienced Jesus, the risen Lord, and the breaking of the bread, they couldn't help but tell the story, what they're witnessing to the disciples. We saw the risen Lord in the breaking of the bread. And as they're telling the story, Jesus appeared to them right there in the room. The room was locked, and he appeared right in before them. And they were frightened. Wouldn't you be? I mean, you saw him die. And all of a sudden, they think he's a ghost. And they're frightened. Yet, Jesus says, look at my hands. Look at my side. Look at everything. Touch me. It really is me. I'm not a ghost. It really is me. But he just appeared to them. Just appeared in the room. But I'm not a ghost. Matter of fact, give me something to eat. A ghost can't eat. Give me something to eat. To really prove the fact, and Martin Luke's telling the story, to prove the fact he has risen. He's obviously different, but he's the same person who died. He's risen. And Jesus goes on to tell them, the very first thing he says to them when he appears to them is, peace be with you. The first thing he says. He probably said it in Hebrew. Shalom Aleichem. And it's not a greeting like, hey, I've been gone for a while, how you doing? That's what shalom means. It means the fullness of life. It's a wish of the fullness of life. It's a blessing of the fullness of life where there's people are reconciled to each other. We're not apart from each other. We're reconciled to God. We're reconciled to each other. We're forgiven. That's the peace he offers us. So think about it when we offer peace today. It's not like the 60s. It's much more about wanting fullness of life, of wanting forgiveness and reconciliation, because we cannot bring it to ourselves. It's only Christ who offers it. So he says, Shalom Aleichem, peace be with you. That's what he wants to give them. They're frightened, but he wants to give them peace. And then he even says, what's going on here? He explains to them, as he did to the people, the two men who went to Emmaus. This was all part of the plan. I was to suffer, die, and rise on the third day. It's the fulfillment of what was done in the scriptures, and the prophets, and the Psalms. I'm fulfilling this. This is not new. You know this. And this is the significant part. He says, I've come to expiate or to end all the sin in the world for repentance, for forgiveness. So I'm here to bring forgiveness. Isn't that what shalom is? Peace, fullness of life, forgiveness, reconciliation. I've come to give that. And he says, and you are witnesses to this, to all these things, but he's come to do. So what does it mean for us to be witnesses of the resurrection? Witnesses of shalom. What does it mean for us to believe that Christ has truly risen? Even in the second reading, first letter of John, he says, he's come to reconcile us to one another. That's why he's here, to show forgiveness. So how am I witnessing this? First of all, I think we need to look at, I heard the first story is, how do we witness the resurrection through a smile, through a hug? That's the first witness we can do. It's not just with the words, but with our actions. So even when he says, you are to witness the reconciliation, that's just to say, Christ is risen, he's forgiven us, and that's good enough. It's to live it. That's the witness, to live it. Matter of fact, in the early church, the word witness, testimony, they used a different word for that. It was called, you are not only a witness, you are a martyr. Martyr is the Greek for witness, testimony, testify. People testified even with their lives. We call them today martyrs. They testify. They're witnesses of the good news of Jesus Christ to bring reconciliation to the whole world. And believe me, we need it, don't we? I need it personally, but we need it also in our society, in our world. We need peace, the shalom that Jesus offers. I remember when my brother Dan was dying of cancer. And I was at a meeting with my Crozier community, and we were having at the time, it was evening prayer. We were having a prayer together, nice, beautiful prayer service. I knew he was dying. I didn't know when. I knew he was dying. So I had a great prayer service. I was praying for him. It was marvelous. And after the prayer service, I went to the sacristy to put things away, and I got a phone call. Phone call said, Dan died. Okay. And I just turned, and I started crying. I knew he was dying, but I was crying. I know he died. Well, that same day was one of my other confrere, Father Tom, is his birthday. So we're celebrating his birthday that night with cake and ice cream that evening. And he saw me in the sacristy. He came in. This is the birthday boy coming in, waiting to celebrate his birthday. And he sees me crying. And he said, what happened? I said, my brother died. He just came over to me and hugged me and said, we're here for you. That's the witness of the resurrection. I'm not alone in my pain. I'm not alone. I'm not saying, come on, get over it. You can get through this. No, it's just, I'm here for you. That's a witness. My twin sister got married to this man, David. None of my brothers liked David. He didn't like Catholics, but that didn't help, you know. One day, I got news from my sister that he was unfaithful. And all my brothers said, divorce him. Remember, they don't like him. Divorce him. And my one sister, Mary, said, well, if my husband cheated on me, he's gone. And my sister said, but I love him. I need to forgive him. And we need to get some counseling because I can't live this way. But she was willing to forgive. It wasn't easy. I'm not like, what you did was okay. No, it was not okay. So they needed counseling. But she goes, I love him so much, I want to forgive him. shows he's willing to do the process of forgiveness. Our society says if you're hurt, you have every right to hurt back. Every right. Every right to hate the person who hurt you. You have every right. I think our Christianity says when you're hurt, you have every right to feel the hurt, and it's terrible. We also have every right as a witness that Christ has offered forgiveness. It's not the easiest thing. I hear confessions constantly, people saying, I can't forgive this person, I can't forgive that person. We can't without the grace of God. We can't forgive. If we're only concerned about our pain and hurt, we can't forgive. We need to realize what Christ can do in our life, how he can change it. Our witness, I think the best witness as Christians is not saying we're always loving each other, because we don't, okay? The big, great witness of the Christians is we can forgive each other because we fail. We know we fail. They're willing to forgive. Yeah, that's one of the hardest things it is to live as Christians, to be the witness of the shalom that Jesus offers us. The invitation for us today is to be martyrs. English translation, to be witnesses. And it's hard. I can't imagine how the early church did it. It's hard even now. It's only through the grace of God. And maybe it will help to start with a smile and a hug.
Has been proclaimed at today's liturgy and broken open by today's homily. These are some of the ways that we can live as Christian disciples in mission.
Hey everyone, whether you're here in person or watching online, we're grateful to have you joining us for Mass this weekend. I'm Liam, here in the Youth Garage, here to tell you what's going on in our community. This weekend is our Baby Bottle Drive collection. Contributions to this drive go to support the Aid to Women Center, a Catholic pro-life pregnancy center that supports women in need. They serve more than 200 women per week in three centers in the Phoenix area, and they rely on individual donors for 93% of their funding. Fill your baby bottles with a check, cash, or coins, and you can return it to the collection bassinets outside or in the narthex. You can also make your donation by credit or debit card at the tables after Mass. Thank you for your generosity in supporting this pro-life organization. Next Saturday, April 20th, we're hosting our Ministry Appreciation Dinner. This dinner is the opportunity for our staff and the leadership to thank all of our parishioners who go out and serve others. However you serve, come after the 4:30 p.m. Mass on that Saturday and enjoy barbecue and community as a gesture of our gratitude. You can RSVP on our website at the link on the screen. And as always, you can find more information on ways to get involved and build community in our bulletin, weekly email connection, and on our website.
As people of faith, then, let's profess our one faith together. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With the disciples who witnessed from Emmaus, let's ask Christ to stay with us a while and answer our prayers.
For the church, that the Spirit will open our minds to understand the scriptures and empower us to share the message of God's love and forgiveness with all whom we encounter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of faith, that we will depend more fully on God in every aspect of our lives and grow in our confidence that God will never abandon us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of forgiveness, that we will be open to God's free and generous forgiveness and strive to forgive others as we have been forgiven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children who are receiving First Holy Communion and confirmation this spring, that they will experience God's love for them and God's care and protection each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all present in this holy place, and for all who recognize the Lord in one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially Ellen Bretzky, Molly Murphy, Paula Murphy, Marcia Markstrom, Jack Walenchik, Larry Anderson, Chris Anderson, Tony Ortiz, and for those who have died, Anne Marie Odo, Rebecca Gonzalez, Patrick Coyle, Paul Markstrom, and Renee Colley. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also remember our Jewish sisters and brothers with all the conflicts going on, especially with Iran. Let's pray for the end of the conflict and that it won't get more, won't get even more complicated there with that in that area. May God shower his shalom to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
O loving Father, you open our eyes to your Son who is among us. Hear our needs and grant that what will bring us closer to you, all that we need, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Be seated as the Ministry of Hospitality comes forward with the baskets. In the moment, you can come forward also to with your monetary gifts, your prayer requests, and your service offerings. And then you know that the access, all those things are offered by the parish staff every Wednesday. We pray together, remember all that's going on here. So know that we are praying for you.
And as we come forward to offer the gifts to the Lord, please sing with us In the Breaking of the Bread.
Once I was heaven,
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name.
Amen. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church. And as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his resurrection is our life that has also risen with him. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with all the angelic hosts, sing together the end and the hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rise of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and in giving you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May it make of us an eternal offering to you, we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, Eduardo his assistant bishop, with the order of bishops, all the clergy, the religious, and the entire people you have made your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let no one caught in sin remain inside the lie of inward shame. But thanks arise upon the cross and run to him who showed great love and plan for us. Freely is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Beneath the weight of all our sin, you bow to none but heaven's will. No scheme of hell, no scoffer's crown, no burden they can hold you down. In strength you sting. Oh, hell, where is your victory? Oh, church, come stand in the light. The glory of God has defeated the night. Singing, oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, hell, where is your victory? Church, come stand in the light. Our God is not dead, he's alive, he's alive. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart and flesh may fade, fresh anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your lives.
Sing with us now, happy day.
And oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never be the same. Forever I am changed. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. At last, meeting face to face, I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. In this joy.